Hi, today I'm going to tell you all about my favorite painting. This is this one. I painted it a little bit more than 1 year ago, and it's called We Are All of This. What you see here, this is what we are. I'm going to tell you in a minute what it's all about, and it's the global thing is it's about oneness, that you are everything. Everything is energy, but everything is also more than that. So it's also about different kinds of perspectives. It's almost the story of Brahma, the Lord Brahma. I will show you. You maybe recognize it. You can see from different perspectives. To understand that, I have a little example. What was happened to me years ago, I had a car accident, and in that car accident, in the rehabilitation period, I had to be 1 year in a wheelchair. So from stand up, I had to sit down a whole year. And literally your perspective changes because you see different things on a different level. And this is also about that. And if you change perspective in real life, but also in spirituality, it really have a chain reaction because people also will react on your new perspective. It's like when I became in a wheelchair and I was in the city with my mom and I asked someone a question, people didn't answer me, but they answered my mom. So the treatment is also, and I was not stupid or like something disabled in my head, but if I change perspective, people also treat you different. And it's also with spiritual process, if you change things, there will be a reaction also from the outside. And it's not always nice, of course. We are all this. I paint what I see in my visions. And this was my first painting. I never thought I really could paint. And I made it then a little bit more than a year ago. I made art already, but more 3D art. And I had this vision. I had to paint it. And afterwards, I channeled information from source or from God. I rather call it source because it's like consciousness itself. And afterwards, I got a lot of information what they mean with this painting. So I'm like, how do you say it? A hatchback or a doorway for energy. And so it just come and then I do what is asked, something like that. Something like that. I'm really surprised that there still are messages in this painting for me. And it's also like codes and keys that I didn't expect that were in this painting. So I will start with the one who is not on this painting, but very important. You don't see what I mean, but it's you is also a part of this painting because you are the observer of this painting now, and without you, the painting doesn't exist for you. So that said, it's also important that you grasp that or have that in mind. You have an overview of this all. What you see here is these blocks are colorful and they are light, but still blocks. We are light, we are color, we are form. We are matter. We are like a pixel. that is built up. Like matter is something that. So the block stands for that, our essence. And I will start with the face. The face, the Buddha face, is like I painted it and it was said to me, so I don't want you to think that I really thought that by myself, but it is a mirror reflection how the creator or how source sees us. It's like transformed mirror reflection from ourselves. We are divine, and that's why the Buddha is there. But we don't see ourselves that way. We only can see ourselves in a mirror, and this Buddha is like the mirror reflection of yourself. That is how they told me. But as you can see, it looks if it's from stone because it's gray. And the gray is built up from colorful blocks. So inside, everything still exists. But it's also not, how do you say it? It's still, we think it's hard, but it's also just built up, you know, like. You see this little puppet? He is creating. And he creates what he thinks is beautiful. The creator stands for our free will and also it's non-judgmental. So he knows more what he wants to create. And he can build the nicest things. You can see that because he built a Buddha here. So his point of view, you really have to go into his perspective. He have blocks and he can build a doll. The two puppets in the eyes, they're a little bit funny, and they are funny. They cannot see themselves, they cannot see each other because of the noses between, and they only have an outlook. So there's a different perspective from them. These two puppets are the voices in your head. They're really like that. You have male and you have female. And they have a relationship, but they cannot see each other because of the nose. But these two are having a lot of discussions. They are chattering in your head. And if you have no balance in these two, the creator will have a difficult time because he's not judgmental. So one is sending out, I want to have this, and one is sending out that. Then it's like radio tune in, it's getting too disturbed for the creator. So if you do spiritual work, it's very important that you get the voices in your head in line. So this one can create. And the two puppets are saying, I want to have this. And this one said, okay, let me give you an example. This one wants to have a car, but this one is too scared to drive. Then it's a little bit confused for the creator. And what does the creator do then? It say, okay, I will give you a car because that was the first one who asked. So he create a car. In real life, you get a car or you win a car. But the other one also sent that message, I don't want a car. So 2 days later, your car gets stolen. And that is happen if these two are not in line. And that is like really a spiritual lesson to get them on the same page. Really, it's like a relationship. How you do that is really go in yourself and see who is dominating or who is the one who is dominating the other. And you will be surprised, because if you can do that, that communication with yourself, just take another position, like really be observing what is happening in your mind. And that is the observer, but also the creator. You can, if you get quiet, observe what the thoughts are telling you and where it came from. And then, if they come in line, the creator can create it. It's really like a straight line then, that he gets his message, what you want. He's not judgmental, but they are. And they only see in the outer world. We on Earth, we live more from these two. But as you see, there are so many things going on that you don't realize that they are. I want to tell you more about the colors I didn't knew before, but here you see a big green block. It's the only big green block on the canvas, and it has to do, and I didn't know that also, it's your heart. It's your chakra color is your green. So if you're in your heart, the creator has really, if it's something made with love, he can really create fast. You have blue head and orange. The blue stands for your throat chakra, and orange for your second chakra in your belly. And I forgot the names of it. But so these three colors, it's like passion, it's like the expression, and from your heart, these three things are the important thing to create. So you see also they have orange hair and they are funny. And fun is also in your belly. Fun and so they are sometimes very serious, but they just want to have fun. And that's why they have to mess things up sometimes. They just do that in yourself. And take a look. The outside of the Buddha is gray, and but you can see they are colored blocks. So we make them steady, but in real they are also just matter. And what I find also a strange outcome that is from the other painting I made, that I already saw on this painting, we are living in a gray area, in a gray zone. So that is also reflecting in this painting. The Buddha face is really like a mirror, a reflection of yourself. It's a divine. But we don't see it like that. Most of the times we don't recognize ourselves as something that is divine. It's already very beautiful. I think I just wanted to share you this, and I hope you liked it. If you have some questions, just ask. And I hope you subscribe, give a comment or like what you want. And thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.